Hi, I'm Super Dragon, and tonight we're going to be looking at some cake shake in Chicago, or the Chicago area. I don't fucking know. We'll just watch.
Portillo's is known across the country for its savory hot dogs and crispy french fries. But most Chicagoans know that Portillo's best kept secret is its cake shake.
Cake shake. I've heard of something like this. But I'm more of a vanilla cake type of dude.
The Portillo's location here in Summit, Illinois is known as the train's sweetest summit.
Ain't nothing sweet about Illinois. 60 to 200 of these a day. Holy shit. On a Saturday morning.
She's been with Portillo's for 9 years and has been making the cakes and cake shakes ever since she started working here.
Is it truly chocolatey and decadent? It's very moist and delicious.
People are still shocked when you tell them, hey, we bake these on site fresh.
The cake mix starts with its dry ingredients, baking cocoa flour, baking powder, and baking soda.
There's always been this rumor that Portillo's cake has mayo in it.
Are you fucking serious? Mayo? That's a hate crime towards sugar. It better not be mayo! And high. Why don't you just make red velvet? Yeah. In other words, burnt. I don't know, I kind of like melting frosting.
The cake is not homemade, and is in fact just your traditional classic fudge frosting.
So we're going to first put a tiny little dot on the bottom to help the cake stick, and then we're going to flip it upside down so that the finished product has a more even look, and so the two pieces stick together. So we're almost making a hamburger out of the cake. And then what we're going to do is we're going to take our first pan of frosting, and we're going to spread it out as evenly as we can.
Pound of frosting? Wow. It's two trips to the dentist's in one day.
And then we're going to take our second pound of frosting, and we're going to put it on top and wrap it around all the sides. But we're not really going for perfection. We're going for homemade.
I like this sweet, but this is good. Very good. All along that I've been going on Portillo's, I usually get a piece of my
beef, beer, and cake.
It's good.
Nasty.
The frosting really does it. Some of it's just kind of like toasty or something.
I'm not a big fan of like the whipped cream, so the frosting kind of does it. And just the cake itself is
super moist.
It's moist and spongy.
Moist and spongy. That's funny. I'm sour.
This is literally the perfect guilty pleasure for anyone wanting to eat their feelings.
I have no feelings except rage.
But you can't eat Portillo's chocolate cake. You've gotta try the cake shake. According to Kara, back when Portillo started making Gina Portillo's cake recipe, they could only serve them the day they were made, because that's about how long they stay fresh for. So
just one day?
They started putting pieces of cake into a cake shake, and they started selling it, and it's been a success ever since. And I grab her cup.
Well, ain't nothing wrong with working hard on it, that's for sure. You know, I've actually, now that she mentions it, I actually have had a cake shake, but it was funfetti ice cream. Yeah, funfetti is basically my favorite type of cake. Chocolate syrup. Used for ice cream, that's for sure.
And then we're gonna break up some of the chunks of that piece of cake that's in there, so you can actually drink it through a straw, or with your spoon on the side.
Drink it through a straw, that's what I do.
You want a little bit of thick chunks in there, just for a bite, but not a lot. Then we're gonna put a little bit of
chocolate on the top of that. This is so appetizing, it's actually making me feel nauseous. Chunks. It would be hard to suck it up. I've had my experience. And it's a pretty big cake slice. It's like big enough to fit into my hands. Yeah, I would recommend it too. Unless you have diabetes or cavities. I don't. I like it in the Southeast. Even though the Southeast doesn't really have fairs. So, yeah, that's shocking. While that does look good, be careful going to Chicago. Just saying. Okay, I'm feeling nauseous. We're gonna end this, because I literally feel like I'm gonna hurl. See y'all next week. Bye.